The Vampiress by Lord Lytton. Found a corpse with glittering hair of a woman whose face, though dead, the white death in it had left still fair, too fair for an earthly bed. So I loosened each fold of her bright curls rolled from forehead to foot in a rush of red gold, and kissed her lips till her lips were red and warm and light on her eyelids white. I breathed and pressed unto mine her breast till the blue eyes opened and the breast grew warm. And this woman, behold, arose up bold and lifelike, lifting a willful arm with steady feet from the winding sheet, stepped forth to a muttered charm. And now beside me, whatever betide me, this woman is night and day, for she cleaves to me so that wherever I go, she is with me the whole of the way. And her eyes are so bright in the dead of the night that they keep me awake with dread, while my life blood pales in my veins and fails, because her red lips are so red, that I fear 'tis my heart she must eat for her food, and it makes my whole flesh creep to think she is drinking and draining my blood, unawares if I chance to sleep. It were better for me ere I came nigh her, this corpse ere I looked upon her, had they burnt my body with penal fire with a sorcerer's dishonour. For when the devil has made his lair in the living eyes of a dear dead woman, to bind a man's strength by her golden hair and break his heart if his heart be human, is there any penance or any prayer that may save the sinner whose soul he tries to catch in the curse of the constant stare of those heartbreaking, bewildering eyes? Comfortless, cavernous, glowworms that glare from the gaping grave where a dead hope lies, it is more than the soul of a man may bear, for the misery worst of all miseries is desire eternally feeding despair. On the flesh or the blood that forever supplies life more than enough to keep fresh in repair, the death ever dying which yet never dies.